Washington State withdraws from the Title X Family Planning Grant Program rather than following new rules that ban recipients of those grants from referring women for abortions. This news comes as the state's lawsuit against the Trump administration plays out. In a letter to the Department of Health and Human Services, state officials write, quote, "These new rules require our providers to deprive their patients of the information and services they need to make and carry out fully informed decisions about their reproductive health." Join me now to take a closer look at the Trump administration's Protect Life rule and what these withdrawals from the program mean is Michael New, associate scholar at the pro-life Charlotte Lozier Institute. Michael, welcome back to the broadcast. Many pro-abortion advocates are saying that the decision by Planned Parenthood and others to leave the Title X program will hurt public health. What's your reaction?
I don't think that's the case at all. It's interesting. Texas, back in 2011, pursued a policy very similar to what's happening at the federal level, and they excluded Planned Parenthood from the state family planning program. And since that time, public health trends in Texas have been very positive. The minor birth rate since 2011 has fallen by 49%. The minor abortion rate's fallen by 57%. The overall abortion rate's fallen by over 25%. There's really no evidence of substantial increase in unintended pregnancies. So the experience of Texas shows very clearly that you can have public health trends that are positive without requiring taxpayers to fork over billions of dollars to Planned Parenthood every year.
What do you see as the political ramifications now that Planned Parenthood and others have decided to withdraw? I mean, how likely is this going to play with voters, do you think?
I think politically it's going to be helpful for pro-life candidates. Most people do not really want their taxpayer dollars either subsidizing abortion, either directly or indirectly. Mm-hmm. So again, this is something that pro-lifers have campaigned on. I think pro-life voters see this as a promise that pro-life politicians and President Trump are trying to uphold. So I think it's going to be a net positive for pro-life candidates in the 2020 elections.
And we'll see. I mean, you know, of course, they're going to get pushback because of all the money that Planned Parenthood puts into this. Where are the newly freed up federal funds likely to go? And do you think faith-based programs will benefit?
Yes, I think that first off, this doesn't cut funding for Title X. It just allows other places to apply for these grants. All of the money might go to fairly qualified health centers, which tend to be more geographically spread out than Planned Parenthood's. They tend to be more likely to be in rural areas. They offer a wider range of services. And it was very interesting. New York Times actually this past week ran a good article, a sympathetic article, about a pregnancy help center in Tennessee, a rural part of the state. And again, it's not always clear that if these pregnancy help centers, you know, will apply for these grants, but it does show that they're freed up and they can go to a wider range of clinics and kind of a wider range of areas and offer a wider range of services. And I think it'll be a net positive for public health.
I know pro-lifers have been looking for that, to get more of those independent clinics on board. Do you think we'll see other states follow Washington's lead in pushing back or issuing a lawsuit against the Trump administration on this?
I don't know if we'll see other states follow the lead of Washington State, but one thing that I'm always heartened by is that a lot of the exciting developments in the pro-life movement are happening at the state level. It's interesting, there are 18 states, in addition to Texas, that are basically limiting the ability of Planned Parenthood or other abortion facilities to get taxpayer dollars from some or all grant programs. So again, I think that that's reason for hope. I think that the experience of Texas and at the federal level, we can show that hopefully the other states will go ahead and protect their taxpayers from funding elective abortions either directly or indirectly.
Okay, well, like I said, there's so many important issues here to break down, so we appreciate your coming on to give us some of the numbers and to give your analysis. Michael New, associate scholar at the Charlotte Lozier Institute. Thanks, Michael.
Thanks for having me.